Good afternoon and welcome to Sports of the Day. January, I think 13th, maybe 14th, I don't know. I believe it is the 13th day. I have Madden 2001. The classic, the first one, the first Madden at least, on the PlayStation 2. I also own a copy of the NFL Game Day 2001. They're very different. I just like to go through the little thing here. Terry Jackson, running back for the San Francisco 49ers, offering us some advice. Season preview was always the first thing I would go to because I liked to see all the different, I guess, trailers they would come up with for different games. It was a good way for them to kind of show off what they had. This is only the PS2 games. They don't have any of the... They had a bunch of PS1 games as well. Different... I don't know if I would say ports, but they were the same games, but just on the PS1s. They were not quite as good. Also, NCAA Football, NCAA March Madness, and I believe F1, but it was F1 2000 was what it was called, because the F1 games were always like a year behind for whatever reason. Yeah, I'm going to go ahead and get out of that. I actually own every game with the 2001 at the end of it from EA Sports. I'm going to go exhibition here. You do have a variety of modes. I guess I could go through them, but there's no real point. Season, franchise, practice. Okay, so not that many modes. Your rosters are the basic 2001. I don't know if you can create players or not. You can, okay. Like, you go throw into the Chiefs here. Will Shields, okay. And Chester McLaughlin, who paid a lot of money for him. Damn. Oh, God, Tim Gronhard. Lou Bush, Pete Stojanovic. Damn. Okay, that's funny. This would have been before we had. This is when Warren Moon was still playing. Probably before we had Trent Green. No, Todd Collins and still Kimball Anders. No Priest Holmes by that point. He was probably with the Ravens. Yeah. I'm not actually going to be the Chiefs because I have another team I'd like to be. There were certain teams. Also, this was the first one to have the NFL Europe teams, and then we have a bunch of classic teams. Yes. I tend to pick the Dolphins in games like this for whatever reason. Oh, the other team be the Jets. That sounds good. Tend to either be the Dolphins or the Jets if I'm playing games from around this era. Actually, let's do somebody else. Oh, that the Eagles, yeah. You see Donovan McNabb run around a little bit. This would have been Andy Reid's second season as head coach. They have alternate uniforms. Ooh, they have classic uniforms. That's cool, I guess. We're just going to stick with typical ones. They didn't have the orange ones by this point. Load time is pretty bad. The early PS2 games, especially because I am playing it on one of the original PS2s, one of the huge bricks PS2, the original one. I had a slim one, but it broke, and I bought a used one, and this just happened to be the one that I got. Damn, when did that slim one break? I think it broke May of 2010. That was when that slim PS2 broke. Yeah, that old slim PS2 was one of my favorite things. Oh, I skipped past all the pregame whatever, sorry. Oh, so they're going to receive. This game is a lot different. It's the first game to use this engine, but it is so much different than the later games to come. 2002 and 2003 kind of set this whole different feeling of game out of the series. And then once it got to 2004, it's still the same engine, you can definitely tell, but there were just so many tweaks by 2004 that it's just so much different. play. I didn't mean to do that. I don't think I can see my play before the play starts. Oh, shit. Okay. Well, that's one way to start. Okay. 78 yards just right off the bat. Yeah, I used to, I never actually owned this game until, I think, 2006 or 5. It was a game that I bought just because the Blockbuster by my house was, it sold used games, and I had, like, $5 on me. And they had a copy of Madden 2001 for 99 cents. And I was like, I've never seen a game for that low of a price before. And I bought it. So that's how I ended up with a copy of Madden 2001. The first game that I bought when I got my PS2, you might not believe this, was NCAA Football 2002. Even though I bought my PS2 in 2004. I forget why. It was a reward for something, for like a string of really good report cards or something. See, this is not the Dolphins running back I'm used to. Or that I think of, at least. When I think of this game, I think of this guy Conrad. I don't remember his first name. But he would just always fall forward. I had like so many 100-yard rushing games with this fullback, and you never get big gains from a fullback, except for in whenever I was playing Madden 2001. And I don't know if this is Damon or Brock Heward, but let's try a pass. Actually, let's try a run first to set up the pass, as one is wont to do. Oh, yeah, that's good. Oh, shit. There's a fumble right there. We recover it, no big deal. Just like the Oregon Ducks last night. It turns out my prediction on NCAA Football 2005 was totally correct, and the Ducks did indeed lose. It was by much more than 3 points. I wanted Oregon, I'll admit that, just because I'm not a big Ohio State fan, and I've always wanted to see Oregon win, just on the big stage, because I think they're an exciting team, and they're a fun team to watch. But if Ohio State, I mean, I'm not that broken up about it, it's not my conference, you know, so, it doesn't really matter to me. I'm not so sure I would want Baylor if Baylor. If Baylor was in the Final Four, I'd want them. I don't want TCU though, or Texas or Oklahoma. See, he's just so hard to take down. He's like a Christian Okoye used to be on the Tecmo Super Bowl for the NES. I think they only have two plays that really go to him, but people just don't tackle him. So I'm racking up huge gains with this dude. I don't even know his first name. Rob Conrad. And fun story about Rob Conrad. About last week, he was on a boat that sank, and he swam for 8 hours back to shore. And which is why I thought to play this game. Because I saw it... I saw, like, the news story on a website, and I was like, oh, I'm not surprised. Dude was impossible to bring down in Madden 2001. Should also figure out which Heward that is. I'm sure it'll show me at some point. Actually, I'm going to look that up right now. It's going to bite at me. It's Damon. I don't even know if Brock played in the NFL. I'm sure he did, but that's beside the point. Damon played in Kansas City for a little bit. I forget. I think it was 2006 he played here. He was okay. He was like better than Tyler Thigpen. Not as good as Trent Green, but Trent Green was old by that point. That was a touchdown. No, it wasn't? What? Okay, I want to see if I can. Challenge status. What does that mean? That means challenge. That means okay. Where is like in-game strategy substitution settings? I guess I can't. I would really like. I don't know if you can challenge the player or not. In the later games, you can. In this game, you can't. I will, however, look at the instant replay, just for the sake of it. Oh. Yeah. All right. Okay. Fine. Whatever. I forget this is the controller with the weird right joystick that sometimes moves. Granted, so few games that I play on this console even use the right joystick. I don't want to do a field goal. Let's see what the coach has to say. Alright, well, we'll kick a field goal. It's my holder. Is that Jay Fiedler? And here comes the kicking unit. 2000 would have been the last year, I think, that Steve Young played. Who won the Super Bowl that year? It was just off of the Rams winning it, so it would have been the Baltimore Ravens. The New York Giants. Am I correct? Yes? Yes, I am. I had to think about it for a second. That is a time that I do not remember whatsoever. I was 5 years old. And it's a time I'm really glad I wasn't my age now and watching football, because I would have been just so bored. It was like, this year in the pro game has left me very bored. I don't care all that much anymore. Especially like this coming weekend. The fact that the Cowboys got eliminated. Like, I don't even like the Cowboys. And if any team could have made it to the championship like game, I would have rather seen Detroit. But okay, somebody take fucking Deuce Staley down. I don't even know if that's his real name. I have to look it up now. I can't let myself live without knowing this. Yep, I was right. Haha. So the 2000 Eagles were probably McNabb, who would have been coming off either his rookie year or his second year in the league. Probably wouldn't have been. I don't know if it would have been a James Thrash by that point. Fred Mitchell or no, Brian Westbrook? Brian Mitchell. Brian Westbrook wouldn't have been there. Mitchell may have been there. He may have been in Washington by that point. He had an awful receiver that just somehow kept being his go-to guy for years. I forget who it was. Everybody, like, laughed at the team. I only remember James Thrash because people called him James Trash, but he had Todd Pinkston, and everybody called him Todd Stinkston because he wasn't good. I always thought he was okay, but it wasn't until he got Terrell Owens that it was like Terrell Owens, however you pronounce his name, T.O., in 2004 that they really got good. Ah, damn it, okay. Well, my defense is not working too well. The Dolphins' defense was pretty good, though, if I remember. I mean, like, this, Zach Taylor and Zach Thomas, Jason Taylor. Probably before Patrick Surtain. Damn. This was the year after Marino retired. In 99, the Dolphins had a weird team. This may have been still... No, this was a Wanstead team. This was after Jimmy Johnson got fired. 2000, though, they had... They just had a weird season. They had a guy named Kareem Abdul-Jabbar at a running back. And Dan Marino was still quarterback, but he had like a 1,000 yards rushing in that season. They made the playoffs. Like, it was the last time they made the playoffs in Marino's career. See, all these moves don't happen as fast as I want them to. He's kind of sluggish on the spinning around, and the juke is weird. It's not like what I expect. Granted, Conrad can do whatever he wants, apparently. Let's see how the screen works. I remember in Madden 2003 was the first time I ever tried to use a screen. I hit Marshall Faulk, and I got like an 80-yard touchdown on a screen play, and I was just like, my God, it's magic. And I never managed to do it again until I actually figured out what a screen really was. Ah, well, okay, Rob. Can't win them all. That other running back, I don't know his name, is doing pretty well, too. It'll come up. Johnson. Was it Bert Emanuel? I don't know who Duffy is. Let's just see if we can hit Martin. Ah, come on, man. So I'm going to have to punt again. You can't see it, but my CRT is going fucking haywire. It is about to breathe its last CRT breath fairly soon, probably within the next year. But I can't really do anything about it because the last time that we had to move this TV, my dad had to get surgery because it, like, killed his back. Because this is a heavy piece of shit, this TV. I have another one. So I have another CRT that works infinitely better than this one. I prefer the CRT. I know I'm not talking about this game right now, but I don't really have too much to talk about. The Eagles are going to kick my team's ass. And I'm sad. Maybe I could use a different formation. But, yeah, I like to use a CRT for, like, the PS2 and stuff. If I can, just because it doesn't like scale it up or anything. I tried playing a PS1 game on my HD TV, like a 44 inch big screen HD TV, and it just looked terrible because it exemplifies everything. And so you can see everything. God damn it, again! That was me being fucking not good at running. I might just stop this at halftime and show another team. Because there's not too many questions left for the outcome of this game. Oh, hey, Patrick Surtain is there and did not make the play. Damn, my defensive back on that end is having quite the day. 173 yards on him already. Not even halftime. I had also a Madden 2001 for my Nintendo 64. But that was the first game that I ever remember, like, it being a dad game. Because I remember, it was my N64, I got it for Christmas. But it was the first game that I remember my dad had. And it was like, God, this is way too complex for me. And I had played Backyard Football for the PC before that. And I would go into Madden, and it was, like, I don't remember if my dad kept that cartridge with him, like, in his office for some reason, because there were games that he would do that with. Like, The Sims, I wasn't allowed to play The Sims for some reason. But I had to, like, ask him when I was... He bought that game probably in 2000, and it was probably 2005 by the time I asked him about it. I was like, Dad, do you still have a copy of The Sims? I remember you playing it once. He was like, yeah, do you want it? No, we're not. I was going to say we're about to get to the 2-minute warning, but we're not. It was the first game, though, that I remember being way too complex for me. And as I stated, I already had a Backyard Football, and I was fine with that. You could play that game with a mouse. It was the only football game I ever remember being able to play with a mouse. I'm just going to fucking fade it. Oh, God, what the fuck? This is uncalled for. I don't know if anybody saw that, but my screen just fucking changed the rules on me. Please don't do that again. Okay. Whew. I was just like, damn, what the hell happened to my game? Hey, that's a first down, if I ever saw one. Damon Heward just making some plays here. This Dolphins team in 2000 was weird because I don't remember them being good at anything in particular, and I don't know why I play them, if not just to show off that Rob Conrad is uncharacteristically good. I'm thinking about writing, there's a series of articles called, like, the greatest athletes and teams in video game history, especially, because it's weird, like, when a team overachieves so much just because of the way they are in a game, or just the way that a game is laid out happens to be perfect for them. Like, Madden 2005's engine totally overrated Ray Lewis, and just because he was on the cover in the Baltimore Ravens that year. And so if you played a game, just simulated a franchise mode the first season without fail, even though that year I don't think the Ravens were like a sixth seed in the playoffs. I always played as the Titans because I fancied myself a Titans fan because I have relatives who live in Nashville, which is, I do that a lot. I'm not really a Titans fan anymore, even though I do wish them well. But I would always play as the Titans, and I would get to like the second round of the playoffs and then lose to Baltimore. And then Baltimore would always go on and win the championship because they had the best defense. And that was in Madden 2005. And that was, like, uncharacteristically good. And there was a whole thing on Polygon last year about Brian Finneran, who played for the Atlanta Falcons. And, like, Madden did its ultimate team thing, and you could have, like, the ultimate best team in Madden history. And Brian Finneran was one of the players because the guy, in Madden 2004, had some crazy, like, he was a tall guy who was playing wide receiver, but they gave him some crazy high jumping ability because he was so good at blocking punts. It was because of that Michael Vick, he had, like, the highest rating of any quarterback in that game because, again, he was the cover guy. Michael Vick, basically, if you put it in Finneran's area, he would come down with the catch. And I remember that team had terrible receivers. It was like Peerless Price and LG Crumpler. Ah, damn, I should have just thrown it to McDuffie when he was standing still. But we got it to him. There's the touchdown. But yeah, there are certain teams and just players that video games make. Everybody knows Bo Jackson in Tecmo Bowl. But there are just certain just aspects of players become really like advanced or exemplified or over, like, I don't know, it's like hyper realism, where you take one thing that a guy's good at and it's all you know about them, and so you make it really good, you make it like too good. It's like Bo Jackson in Tecmo Bowl. We knew Bo Jackson was strong and fast, but the people who made the game were just like, you've seen this Bo Jackson shit, and he was just the strongest and fastest man in the game. Well, not the strongest, but like Christian Okoye in that game was an interesting example of that, because he was a good player, and he was a fine running back, but he was just like, if you stood still with Christian Okoye, nobody would be able to tackle him in Tecmo Super Bowl. So with an example like Rob Conrad here, he was never a great player. He played for like 6 or 7 seasons, I think, all with the Dolphins. And only ever scored like 8 touchdowns or something like that, which is a pretty decent career for a fullback. I mean, you don't, especially in the modern era, I mean, that's a pretty damn good job by a fullback. But he's not as good in real life as Madden 2001 would make him out to be. Okay. Oh, damn! That was a terrible throw. Okay. Well, come down with it, though. I'm not complaining. He's got 93 yards receiving. I don't know his fucking first name. I'm gonna guess it's James. Tony! Ah, Tony Martin. O.J. McDuffie, and of course, Bert Emanuel. The second receiver that Tampa Bay paid way too much money for, after Alvin Harper. I'm really glad I'm not a Buccaneers fan. It was like, as a Chiefs fan, And as somewhat of a Vikings fan, like, and not that much of a Vikings fan, I only really started following them a couple of years ago because I wanted it. I wanted a second team to follow. Even though the Chiefs are good, I still watch the Vikings just because I like. For whatever reason, I'm fucking weird and want a second team to follow. This is when you call an audible, or don't call an audible. This is when you call an audible. You call Peyton Manning on their asses. So OJ McDuffie should be getting wide open in the corner. Oh fuck, he is. If I had let him cut, he would have actually been wide open. Well, like, at least the Chiefs are good every once in a while. Like, they were 9-7 this season, and that's fine. I'd be just, I'm happy with that, even though we don't have a Super Bowl since the 60s, since 69 to be exact. At least I can go and see a winning team. The Buccaneers have just been so horrendous, except for their one Super Bowl season. And that was the first Super Bowl I ever remember watching. It's weird, like, thinking back to the early 2000s, because I was alive, but I don't remember very much, and I knew more about football than I think I realized I did. I don't know how to run, so we're fucked. Just throw it. Yeah! Oh, come on, man. That's the second drop of the day in the end zone. 4th and 1. Everybody in the stadium knows who we're going to. That's right, Mr. Swims 8 Miles himself. And penalty. So that's a false start holding. Damn! It's always a holding. I would fuck with their heads if I did it again. Well, I just gotta hope for my defense to come up with a stop. Because they've shown that they can do that. I was sarcastic. I've not shown that at all. I wonder how big this file is going to get. It's already at 2 gigs. I will be uploading it for 3 days. I was surprised yesterday when my file actually uploaded, so. What's the score now? 21-13. So I just need a touchdown and a 2-point conversion to tie. That's not too bad. Mayer's not a bad kicker. Okay. I guess it'll be Jason Taylor. I don't remember Jason Taylor, I just know he's good. I remember watching that, there was an NFL Films thing on what was called the Monday Night Meltdown. No. Monday Night Miracle. The Monday Night Meltdown is a completely different thing. But very similar still, where the Jets played the Dolphins and came back in the second half and it was Vinny Testaverde, but these Jets fans were just fucking yelling at Jason Taylor the entirety of the pregame. And at some point he acknowledges them. And it's like, hey man, these dudes have been talking shit all day. And we like cuts to the guys in the crowd and they're like all surprised that he looked at him. And it was my recap of an NFL Films Presents episode. See, here's the thing. He's thrown into coverage, and I just can't do anything. And also, immediately sends me back to the 4-3, which is what I don't want to do. They've been quite simply unstoppable. This was the first example of the comedic Lions crew. As you saw right there, the man just kind of fell down. Oh my god. This team is so bad. This is like the secondary. I forgot that it was just this fucking awful. Should play like Washington or somebody. Because that's like an individual athlete thing, is when you have somebody in coverage still make a catch. They missed that. Oh, no, wait, that was me with the 13 one. They missed an extra point. No, they never do. There was a KU game earlier this year where they missed an extra point and it came back to bite them. It was that Oklahoma State game. Yeah, okay, this will be a fun story. KU was playing Oklahoma State earlier this year. They miss an extra point on their first touchdown, but they come back late in the game, and they tie the game up at 20-20 until Oklahoma State runs back the ensuing kickoff, and the game's over. But if we had made that first extra point, they would have been up on Oklahoma State, and things could have been somewhat different. I mean, because that mood's all different. You don't know that they were like, okay, we're down now. We got to just go down and kick the field goal. Don't worry about returning the kickoff or anything. Oh, shit. Ah. Maybe that's the secret to Madden 2001 for the PS2. Just throw the ball to the left side. Maybe I'll kick the on. I'll do an onside kick if I score here. That's what I'll do. Tight end post corner. What am I getting with this? I guess Goodwin. Yeah, Martin. Be open. Okay, Tony Martin. I think that puts him over 100. Oh, he's well over 100 already. So the end of this game is pretty much set, unless I can come back with a crazy fourth quarter comeback against the Eagles. Granted, that would probably require my defense making a stop at some point in the game. That was stupid. So I'll take full accountability for that. Second and 10, we use our star running back, or fullback, whatever his title is. It's just rumbling for 9 yards. That's the great thing about a player like this. It's just like, I needed 9 yards there, and I sure as hell got him. I'm dominating in time of possession, but not in points, so... Shit. No. Good goal line. Let me do a quarterback sneak for, like, 3 yards. I'm really hoping my center can just get right through. Yeah! Oh shit, Damon Heward. Like a 10-yard rush there. I'm impressed by that. Flip the play around on the fullback dive to the strong side here. There's really no thing here. I should have hurdled, I guess. My running back, his name I've already forgotten, is who I'm going to give it to next. Nobody's even giving me a room there, so they were okay. That's not bad. And again, everybody in the stadium knows who I'm going to. But you know what? Who cares? He'll get the first down, I think. Duh. Come on, man. This is the quarterback sneak again. For whatever reason, that worked. Ooh, we'll give it to the fullback again. Yeah, he's not going to get this. Ah, fuck me. Come on. Well, I guess I'm just going to rush everybody. So you know I've given up. If they can get this playoff, I'm dead. I'm already basically dead. Oh, shit. Is that a safe? No, that was a down to the 1 yard line. Ooh, okay. Let's do jam middle again. See if they try to pull that again. Okay, they're in the I form. That's good news. I'm just gonna take my hands off the controller here for a second. This is a strategy I like to call don't fuck it up. I bet they go pass here. And it's 99 yards for the touchdown. If we can get the safety here, it'll make the game slightly different because we will get the ball back. But never underestimate my ability. Not. Oh, shit! Ladies and gentlemen, I believe that is the first safety ever recorded on Sports of the Day. Which is why it does pay to go for the, I guess to go for it on fourth down in the red zone. Of course, then the lineman picks up the onside punt. Somebody did do an onside punt recently. I forget who it was. And they got it because that is such an easy thing to do, to come down with an onside punt. Because, like, the best thing you can do on an onside kick is just let it hang up in the air. And punting is literally letting the ball hang up in the air. And I don't know if you noticed, but, touchdown Dolphins. And if I get the extra point here, that'll make it 22-28, meaning if I can score the next time I get the ball, score a touchdown, rather, I will win the game. And also stop the Eagles from scoring. I don't think I want to give the ball back to them, though, because my defense has been shit outside of the one safety we got. But yeah, let's give it back to him. Let's go conservative, because that always works. Going conservative has never failed before. Key here is to kick within the. I wanted to kick it into the end zone. That's not what I wanted at all. Okay, so 35-yard line. And we have figured out that Donovan McNabb is not very good against the blitz. So why don't we use what they like to call the blitz? Be somebody. And I'm going to get a two-minute warning. Hold on. Yes, I do want to call a timeout here. That's right. Because I know I will get the two-minute warning. I didn't want to go back in the 4-3. Shit. Oh. Rushing five. Damn, okay. We're going to lose this battle. This is going to be an Eagles first down. Okay, so I should get, let's let it go to the 2-minute warning. Or do I want to use the timeout before the 2-minute warning? Oh, it's over now. I want to go with the inside blitz because I feel like that's where they're going. And if we don't get it, then the game's basically over. And guess what? We didn't fucking get, oh, there was a penalty. Oh, shit. The Madden hold coming into effect big time. Giving the Dolphins another chance at breathing the life of a champion in this meaningless exhibition game here on Sports of the Day. In a 3 gigabyte video file. Or whatever his name is, Martin. And I will call a timeout, and they are forced to punt. This is my return man, Kelly. I don't know who Kelly is. I have to make sure that if it comes down to it, I will call for the fair catch, and I'm going to need to call for the fair catch. All right, so can Damon Heward lead the Miami Dolphins to a touchdown here in the final 1 minute and 48 seconds of the game? I don't know. It's a stretch, but we'll see. We know where he's going. He's going to his main man, Martin. He makes the catch. Tony Martin, 200 yards receiving. Probably the best day of Tony Martin's virtual career. Real Tony Martin, I've never heard of in my life. We can get somebody here. I don't care. Emmanuel? Yeah, why not? We got one timeout left, right? Yeah, so if I just call the hurry up, we can just kind of hurry up. That'll be a run. That'll be a punt. That'll be a pass. There we go. Same play. Same play. Okay. Shit. Double coverage. Okay, just make sure nobody else gets to it. And he also couldn't get to it. So that's unfortunate. No, I don't want to do the same play. We'll do this. OJ McDuffie going to the corner. And we got Martin doing a little angle thing here. Nice! Damn nice. So now we are with under a minute left. I think I'm going to either throw a fade to Emmanuel in the corner or Martin if they cover Emmanuel. And they'll cover both of them. Or we'll just fucking go to the end zone. He just won't break. Alright. Well, we're going to go to the man who got us here. The man who swam 8 miles. Or 8 hours, whatever. How many? Whatever. Okay. Well, that didn't work at all. Something Johnson for the Eagles is the one. Oh shit, it's 3rd and 8. So let's go to a man. Let's just find an open man. Probably a man in the middle. Yeah! Just don't drop it, Bert. Did he score? Yeah, he did. Yeah, he did. There you go. This is a nice presentation, just by the way. Something nice they added for the PS2 game. I don't remember it ever looking like that in later editions. Those sorts of touchdown celebrations. And so, here on Sports of the Day, the impressive Tuesday afternoon comeback. We don't know that the game's over yet. Still, we only have a 1-point lead. 25 seconds left. The Eagles could very well run this back. I also would like to get the kick into their end zone. And we've seen the Eagles go like 87 yards in one play before, so. Damn it. Oh well. We'll maybe get this? You might know it. Nope, Rossum's going. Okay. Hey! Stop him before he can get to the 20. And now, I don't really want to do the 3-4, so I won't. Or 4-3, whatever. I'm going to rush a couple, not too many. So I still want safeties to be back there. I don't want to prevent, though, because I've been completely unable to stop me. Ah, Jesus Christ. Okay. Ooh. I'll call timeout. Maybe I should prevent. I'm just going to go prevent. Just see what happens. He's 9 of 10 today, so there's really no stopping him anyway. As long as we have people back there. Hey! We broke one up. For the first time in recorded Dolphin history, we broke up a Donovan McNabb pass. Now with 9 seconds left, this will basically be a Hail Mary. Or maybe a short pass, because they still got timeouts. So. Small. Make him stay up. Okay. So they have 3 seconds left. And like 52 yards. This could be the great... Oh, I didn't even go prevent there. I went with man lock. That's not a terrible defense for here, though. As long as nobody's too keen on Deuce Staley out of the backfield. 3rd and 2. 3 seconds left. And McNabb is sacked. Ladies and gentlemen, Sports of the Day with the greatest comeback in Madden history. Madden 2001 history, that is. Dolphins 29, Eagles 28. Off of safety. And a touchdown pass and a fourth quarter comeback led by Damon Heward, of all people. Alright, 322 yards passing, that's not bad. Heward, having a great game. Tony Martin, who is just breaking records left and right. Well, thus ends Sports of the Day for today. Thank you so much for watching.